Let's move ahead. The next thing I want to do is supply our NSURL session with a request. But first, there are a few important things that I want to point out. What we've been calling requests, the NSURL session refers to as task. Also, any task used by NSURL session is a subclass of NSURL session task. Let's break that down. There are three main tasks that we can work with: data task, download task, and upload task. A data task, or an NSURL session data task, returns data from the network directly into memory as one or more NS data objects. The key word for remembering this type of task is data. Data tasks are good for short-lived requests, and we'll be using them exclusively in this course. A download task, or NSURL session download task, returns data from the network into a temporary file. Think of these tasks like downloading a file from the internet. When the task completes, you have a file to work with. And finally, the upload task, or NSURL session upload task. These kinds of tasks are specialized for uploading content. Like I said, in this course, we're just going to focus on data task. To recap, in the code, we have the image URL, and we have the shared NSURL session. So now we're ready to make our request, or a task in this case. To create an NSURL session data task, we need to use the NSURL sessions method called data task with URL. We'll be using the version of this method that takes a URL and a closure called a completion handler, and it returns an NSURL session data task. So I'll go ahead and capture the return value, which is the task, and then I'll specify our image URL. And now let's talk about the completion handler. The completion handler is just like any other closure. It's named completion handler because it's executed after the data task completes, and we can't really be sure when that'll happen. The task might complete in a few milliseconds, or it might take a whole minute. But that's the real power of this closure. It's like us saying, I don't really know when this task is going to complete, but when it does, run this block of code. Now, instead of using this closure, we could use NSURL session's family of delegates to handle running code after the task completes. But we won't be doing that in this course. If you're interested, I'll post links in the instructor notes that cover the NSURL session delegates in more detail. Now, this completion handler takes three parameters. The types of those parameters are NSData, NSURL response, and NSError. Now, if you haven't seen these types before, don't worry. We'll slowly introduce them. For their local parameter names, I'll call them data, response, and error. For now, let's ignore all of them and try printing task finished when the task completes. And we'll build and run this. Well, it doesn't appear to be working because our print statement isn't showing up. Let's talk about why this is next.